I am Hardeep Singh. I have come from Punjab, Ferozepur College of Engineering and Technology, Ferozepur, Punjab, to deliver a speech on how to get research paper published in GRABS Journal. Publishing of research results or our research is the main criteria for our research to get it published, to get it recognized. So writing is not everyone's favorite activity, but getting a paper published in a right journal with the right impact factor in right place is a very tedious and time consuming process. What is a scientific paper or what is a research paper? According to Robert Day, scientific paper is defined as a written and published report describing original research results. I have discussed two models. One is King's model and other is Hourglass model. The structure of the paper contains title, then abstract, introduction, body, discussion, and references. Generally, the paper contains title, after title, then affiliation of the author, to which place it belongs, which university, research scholar, then his department, then university or institution, his affiliation. After that, abstract, introduction, literature review. Literature review is also the very main part of the paper. Then need of the study, why do we are doing that study, then objectives of the study, then research methodology, findings of the study, then results, limitations of your study, then scope of future research, conclusions, acknowledgements. We have to acknowledge the people who have helped in our paper, in our research work, then references, and last is author's biography. Choosing a right title. The main thing is the title of your paper. Title, you should have a right title, concise title. Title should not be very long or it should not be very confusing, because title is the main thing which attracts the reader. Then abstract. What is abstract? An abstract summarizes your work. In the paper, it is just a summary of your paper in which you add about its problem, the problem on which you have worked, then objectives of the study, then you also discuss the research methodology in the abstract. After that, some important results, and a last is concluding statement. And after abstract, we have to add 4 or 5 keywords, and abstract should be right, because abstract is the thing. Mostly people read the abstract. If they find the abstract is some fruitful, then we go to the research paper. So abstract is the main thing, and we should write the abstract in a right manner. Then is introduction. Everybody know what is introduction. Introduction is the part of the paper, most difficult part of the paper, because this is the part which introduces the readers about your problem, about your work, about which you are working in this area. Then it contains brief background of the topic area, then existing work, which would lead to the importance or originality of your work, description of your problem, achievements, significance, and brief methodology of your work. Next. What do journal editors want? Journal editors want that in your research paper, your paper should be a good quality work. Then original research work, it should not be copied from anywhere. It should be your own research work. Then active research areas, and main thing is the English or language you have used in the paper, it should be clear and concise. There should be no errors or no grammatical mistakes. Then reading improves your writing. The person or author who is going to write a paper and who wants to write a paper, a good paper, good quality paper, he should have a habit of reading, or he should create a habit of reading. Reading improves your writing. Read as often as possible. Discuss your problem, your paper with your colleagues and friends. It will assist you to select a right journal, and also it will give you ideas, new ideas, and also it will help you to polish your ideas. Then publication ethics. Don't no multiple submissions. Then there should be no plagiarism. It should not be copied from anywhere, and it should not be work of any other author or any other scientist. It should be your own work. Then improper contribution, it means that the author or co-author who is working should be related to your area. He should know about your problems, and that author should not be a dummy author. Only the person who has full knowledge about your paper, about your problem, and who has really worked in the paper, only that person should be added in the paper. Then data fabrication, data falsification, then conflicts of interest. That I have already discussed that the author who is working in the paper, who has authored the paper, he should have full knowledge. There should be he who has not interest in that area, in that paper, he will not work wholeheartedly, and he will not work. So there is no need to add such author or co-author in the paper. Choosing a target journal. Journal selection should be based on honest evaluation of the manuscript. Compare with the stated aims and scope and impact factor of the potential target journals. What is impact factor? Impact factor is the annual average number of citations per article published. What is a good manuscript? Good manuscript contains a clear, useful, and exciting scientific message. It flows in a logical manner that the reader can follow. It is formatted to best showcase the material. It is written in a style that transmits the message clearly. Scientific language is the tenses that we should use in the research paper. Present tense should be used for known facts and hypotheses. Past tense for experiments you have conducted. Then past tense when you describe the results of an experiment. Then conclusions. Conclusions tell us how your work advances the field from the present state of knowledge. Without clear conclusions, reviewers and readers will find it difficult to judge the work and whether or not it merits publications in the journal. Do not repeat the abstract in the research paper or in the conclusion, or just list experimental results. Trivial statements of results are unacceptable in this section. Provide a clear scientific justification for your work and indicate possible applications and extensions. You should also suggest future experiments or point out those that are underway. Then acknowledgements. Recognize the persons who have helped in search work, because we want the helpful people to help us again. So we should give them acknowledgement, give them recognition. Advisors, financial supporters, proofreaders, typists, suppliers, or any other person who have helped in your search work to complete your search. After that, references. References is an area where people make too much mistakes. Most of the mistakes are found in this area. Because if the references are not good, not clear, not right, it confuses the editor, it annoys the editors, reviewers, cite the main scientific publications on which your work is based. Do not inflate the manuscript with too many references. It doesn't make it a better manuscript. Avoid excessive self-citations and avoid excessive citations of publications from the same reason. Then important to remember, preparation is important, but do not spend too much time on your preparation. Submit the paper to the right journal, submit it to only one journal, then check the English, English grammar, English spellings, punctuation, then pay attention to the structure and formatting, pay attention to the journal requirements, and always be honest to your search work, to your search paper, and in selection of the journal. Then worth of your paper. Your paper is worthless if no one reads, uses or cites your paper. A research study is useful only if it is clearly described. Someone else can use it for his or her studies. It arouses other scientists' interest and allows others to reproduce the results. By submitting a manuscript, you are basically trying to sell your work to your community. By submitting a good research paper, good research, you are also helping the society, helping the scientists. Thank you.